Hey guys, thanks so much for joining me. I appreciate it. And like I said, I'm going to be talking about to a friend of mine who is a caregiver for her family. The highs and lows of being a caregiver. There you go. There you go, girl.
Girl, I'm trying to, I'm up here visiting my mother, so it's a busy night. Normally Sunday nights, we talked about it. Normally Sunday nights are peaceful, but they got a
Right.
lot going on tonight. So hopefully we can make this thing happen without any,
Right.
get through it.
Javonna is in Chicago, or the suburb, or are you actually in Chicago?
I'm in Chicago.
Yeah. Either way, it's well, how's the weather right now?
You know, it's probably in the 30s, maybe upper 20s. It was windy as heck. Almost blew me away today. I mean, when I say windy, it was windy, 30, 40 miles per hour wind. But, nonetheless, it's Chicago. It's February. Could be worse.
It is what it is, right? And
Yes.
it could be worse. It's been, and I hate not to rub it in, but it's been a beautiful yesterday, today. I'm like, wow. Whereas one day it's like sleeting, and then the sun the next day, crazy. But today was really a beautiful day. So I want to talk to you about. I know you're the family caregiver for your mom because you grew up in Chicago, then you moved to Texas for a while, then you moved back so you could help take care of your mom, right? I think that's
Oh,
what
well,
happened.
I did move back, but hold on. I've been a lot of places in between here in Texas.
I know, but I'm just saying.
We're gonna keep it simple. We're gonna keep it
Yeah.
simple. All righty, all right.
Not the
Yeah. So the
life story.
last time I did live in the Dallas Fort Worth area, and I was going back and forth between Atlanta and Dallas. So then I came here to take care of her. You're exactly right.
Okay. And so how has that been, being back in Chicago and having to take care of your mom?
You know what? A big change, but I tell people, when you're looking forward to your second half of life, and your duty calls. But if I had to make the
Right.
same decision over again, I would do it all again.
Oh my goodness. Okay, I understand. It's about family, and it amazes me how some people they don't have that family loyalty or connection or love, that bond like that. They don't have that natural affection, and they don't want to, be bothered. They find any way they can to get out of that. But some people take on the responsibility of doing what is necessary.
Well, she was a great mom, still is. She was a great mom. So I'm doing, I just doing for her what she would do with me, So
Right.
that's the difference. Yeah.
Right. I understand that so well. My mom was like, "Hey, if I can't handle it, don't put me in no home." And I'm like, "Okay, mom." Because people see so many stories about the things
Right.
that go on in some places, and some places are horrible, and some places are great. So it
But you
just
still, right now she broke her hip about a month and a half ago. I'm up here every day, and it's a nice place. But you still, they know they're gonna see my face every day.
Yeah,
And
that's
she
key.
never asked. She never made me promise not to put her in a nursing home or anything like that. But that was just my promise to myself, is I'm able to do it, and I am.
Are
So
you an only child?
you would think I am. No, I have two
That
brothers.
another story.
That's another story which we will not talk about tonight, but I am the
I
middle child, only girl.
know.
Yep,
Yeah, I'm
so we
not.
will leave
Yeah,
that
I feel you. Thankfully,
out.
I have two great older brothers, and so I know that it would be a shared situation, and won't have to worry about it. We have talked about it if it ever
Awesome.
comes to
Awesome.
that. So, I know that you are. This is your only income. Well, not your only income, but you are not working outside of being a caregiver, except for the fact that you're an entrepreneur and you have your own business.
Right.
Hey Roy, hey Delene, how y'all doing? Thanks so much for joining. When you heard about the naturally sourced products and what made you decide to get started with it?
Well, first of all, I happen, and to this day, I don't know how I found my coach, Tyrone, but I saw him post, and I would see all these people losing their stomachs. And I'm small. I guess I'm what they call fat or skinny fat, but I had a little tummy. And I said, they could lose their stomach. If this stuff is real, I could lose mine. And long story short, I lost 6.5 pounds in 8 days in my stomach. And that may not sound like a lot, but when your friends and people noticed it, somebody small like me lost that much weight in my stomach. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness gracious. I was ready to tell the world. And that's what I've been doing, because a lot of people need to, lose a lot more than 6.5 pounds, but right. It's a health, it's healthy. And it will be healthy for them as well. Right. So I knew I could help a lot of people.
Roy says I know what you mean, because my mom's had cancer and she asked us if you can put her in a home, but we took care of her until she passed away in January 2013.
Wow.
Yeah. Sometimes people don't want to feel like a burden, but they don't realize you're not a burden. You know what I'm saying? Yes. You're my mom. And Roy, you guys did the right thing in taking care of mom. Hey, Angie, thanks so much for joining. Thanks so much for sharing. Thanks, Renee, for joining. Appreciate that. Did you have any other, health issues? But mostly you just wanted to flatten your stomach because you were not overweight. Didn't have any severe health issues or anything that. Matter of fact, I remember you said that at one point, about over 15 years ago, you were training for a marathon.
I was. I was doing it as a fundraiser. Wait a minute. And you have to understand my backstory. I didn't even tell you that. And my friends said, what, you training for a marathon? I always worked out, but I'm not athletic. Uh-huh. And I was doing some fundraising for the American mm-hmm. Stroke Association at that time. If y'all hear something in the background, that's my mother. That's my mother. So anyway, just in case, and she might holler out. I'm in her room.
That Wi-Fi. Okay, go ahead.
I know. Here we go. Yeah, she had a broken hip, so I'm here visiting her. Anyway, what was that now? I always forget. Anyway, so I was training for a marathon, and I ended up hurting my leg. So long story short, my doctor does say, though, I am her. She said she wished she had more patients like me. But she didn't talk about my little flat tummy, my little tummy. And that's just my issue. It was not big, but.
It was big for you. And the thing about it is that some people might want to be a size 14. Somebody else would be like, ooh, I need to be an 8 or a 10 or something like that. It's about, enjoy the time fundraising for the Americans. What are you talking about, Roy?
American Stroke. That was the American Stroke Association when I was I was doing a fundraiser.
Oh, he enjoyed that. Oh, okay. Yeah. Awesome. Roy, I might need to interview you. And what's going on in your world? But anyway, got what I was saying. So the marathon you didn't actually do it because you injured yourself. So you were in great shape because of that, although you were not somebody who was, again, overweight. And somebody's body and what they're happy with is different for everybody.
Yes,
and there is no one size fits happiness. And so the thing is, most people don't want to be skinny. You know what I'm saying? And for me, it's about being slim. Yeah, I get what you mean, Roy. We figured it out. you want to be smaller, you don't want to be in a healthy state. Your stomach is too big. It don't have to be flat. You don't need a six pack, but if it's too big, then that can create health issues.
Yes.
Because inside you're squishing, all the organs and things like that. So, but people should not make other people feel that because they're not a size 10 or a size 8 or anything that.
This is what I say. One size doesn't fit all, but one size fits healthy.
Exactly.
That's what I want to be. One size fits healthy. Yeah. So.
Thanks so much for doing it, guys. If you like sharing, please do.
Yeah.
This conversation is about being a caregiver and the things you can do to endure that, because it can have its ups and downs when you are caring for somebody that you love. And they're going through different things. It can cause different emotions, and it can stress you out. It can burn you out. And what are some things that you can do in order to keep going and endure that. And so time went on. You became a raw foodist at one point.
I became a, that's when I had a problem with my fibroids, right? When I turned, I've been having, when I was in my 40s, and the very first time I was diagnosed with fibroids, I'm one of these, I believe in doing it the natural way. Uh-huh. Thus, you know, if I can not do drugs, the least amount as possible. So the very first time I took beef out of my diet and my fibroids didn't grow for 3 years, my doctor said, Giovanna, whatever you're doing, keep doing it. And then probably maybe 5 or 6 years later, I had an incident. I had to go to the hospital, and I've been hospitalized twice. And each time they wanted me to have a hysterectomy. I tell people there are two surgeries that are overperformed, hysterectomies and bariatric surgery. We'll talk about the bariatric surgery later. But I told the doctor, let me try again. Let me do what I'm supposed to do. Now, if I come back in there, you can have everything inside. And right. So I stumbled. I got to doing my research, and I found a naturopath doctor, and she turned me on to raw foods. And she said, Giovanna, don't try to go at it 100%, because then you'll feel like if you don't do it, that you failed. So right. Gradually, I started doing raw. I was probably 90% raw. I was never 100%, but I was, and I turned my mom onto it. And I do believe to this day, that's why she's still healthy, even though she has Alzheimer's. And in the process, I became a raw food instructor. I tried to help people then to introduce them to raw food. And I've got people who have died on me since then, but I don't want to give up my steak. And they've given up their life. So when I came across, so when I came across our products, then they were more mainstream and people were more interested. But the funny thing, I know I'm changing subjects. Now I'm running to people who are vegan. And I've not seen so many fat vegans. That's another story. But I've never seen so many fat vegans in my life. Yeah. But they're raw vegans. They're not going to be fat. But still,
they think not eating meat, let's say vegetarian, because I've known people who were vegetarian or vegan for 20 years, but they were overweight because they're just not, they're just eliminating meat. They don't have anything to do with all the crap that you eat. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't just eat a tub of ice cream because you're vegetarian and think that that's going to be okay. It's not. And people need to educate themselves. Mm-hmm. So you got started, you lost the weight, and we have quite a few products, and you only take like the multi-nutrient and the juice on a regular basis. And the multi-nutrient is like amazing, and so is the juice. It helps reduce a lot of inflammation. It's like anti-aging, all those different types of things. So many stories, but those are the two you take regularly, right?
And my trim sticks.
Okay, and one of the products to keep the weight down. It's kind of like a pixie stick, but you put it in water and you drink it, and that helps to keep your weight down, maintain. It tastes great. It kind of reminds me of what Hawaiian punch in a way. Yeah, Hawaiian punch, and then the gold blend juice. Just do a capful of that. It's great. But then the antioxidant. It's like a multi-nutrient, like a multivitamin, but more. If you call it a multivitamin, that would diminish what it actually is. And so, so those are the things that you focus on in order to maintain your health and your mom's health. And
she gets the global blend. She doesn't need to lose any more weight. But the two of us take global blend every morning.
That's amazing. And so outside of being a caregiver, you supplement your income by, you know, helping people to get healthy, because then you say you, I don't know if you have a certificate in.
I'm a raw food instructor. Okay. But I don't use it that much anymore, but I usually share just helping people just be healthy. Right. And, you know, and I'm able to share our products with a lot of people. Mm-hmm. I'm a wellness coach. I'm a wellness coach. And I do some acting just in case, you know, I do some acting on the side, but mainly my income supplement.
Like you said, the second stage of life, you're choosing to do things that you want to do. And have you always done acting? And is that a recent thing, or?
You know what? Over the years, I was in broadcasting. That was really what I started doing. I went to school as I was a broadcast journalism major at the University of Kansas, and I was an anchor, a sports reporter, and done news, radio, sports, and all that good stuff. And over the years, I just, you know, you find other things to do. I enjoyed what I did, but back then, being a female sports reporter was really, really tough. And I didn't necessarily give up, but, you know, you start getting to other things. And one of the things that I pursued was the acting. So now that I'm back in Chicago, I'm starting to make my rounds again. So that's another story. I got so many stories to tell. But my main thing and my main passion is helping people. Either way it goes, I'm having fun. I'm having fun doing the acting. I'm having fun with the health and wellness, because when I help, I love seeing the other side. I love when people call me and say, Giovanna, I dropped 8 pounds. Giovanna, you won't believe this. I dropped 15 pounds. What? You know, but I know it's possible. So when I see that brings a joy to me that, you know, like nothing else does.
Well, I know you're busy, and I appreciate you taking this time. I was trying to be brief this time to allow me to interview you on Conversations with Kim on this Sunday night. And you know, I'm silly. Yeah, Vincent, that's true. Just getting rid of meat and white bread combinations does wonders. That can make a huge difference, guys. If you feel like this video could help somebody, please share it, give me some likes and some loves, and to thank Giovanna for getting on here. And Giovanna, thanks. So last question I want to ask you, what have you done in order to keep from having caregiver burnout or stress?
You know, people ask me that, and I have to tell this story, and I have to be honest, 100% real. First of all, and I said to you earlier, my mom was a wonderful mom, and I have a caregiver support group in honor of her. It's called Olivia's Prayer, the place for caregivers and Alzheimer's awareness in the African-American community. So people come to me to ask, say, they ask me that question, because, you know, even my male lady, she says, you don't act like, because she know, you know, they see me, I'm not always dressed up, but my spirit doesn't change. My mother, maybe it's my mother's spirit, maybe that's what it is, but I tell you, and I have to be honest, if she were mean, she's not. If she had been mean to me coming up, I cannot tell you I'd be able to do what I do. My promise to myself and to my mom, she didn't ask me for this. My promise to is to make her last days her best days. And when I see her, people who know her, you know, she's a sweetheart. She makes it easy. And, you know, so I'm learning balance, to answer your question. I know it took 5 minutes to get there, but I'm learning balance.
I think it's mindset. It's the way you think. It's the way you think about the situation. If you allow a situation to consume your thoughts and turn your thoughts into negative, then you are going to feel that way. But you keep that positive part. We could go on and on and on, but I don't want to. I want to keep this as short as possible. And thank you so much.
My pleasure.
And I will see you in Dallas.
Yes, you will. All righty. Bye, everybody.
Have a good night. Thanks. Guys, I hope about that interview with Giovanna, talking about being a caregiver for her mom. She moved back from Texas to Chicago to do what children do, which is take care of the person who took care of them the most. I was looking up caregiver stress, and it said caregiver stress syndrome is a condition that's, and when you have to take care of a chronically ill person over a long period of time. She set up a caregivers group. If anybody wanted information about that group that she set up in Chicago, let me know, message me, and I get that information to you. If you want more information about the natural resource products that we talked about that helped her to maintain a balance and the anti-aging and the antioxidants, message me and I'll definitely get that information to you. If you've been on the fence and you've been thinking about, Kim, I've been seeing you talk about helping people for 5, 6, 7 years, and I just haven't reached out for whatever reason, and I need to transform my life, message me right now. Hey Jermaine, how you doing? Hey Tamita, how you doing? Thanks so much guys for joining me. If you have some topics you want me to cover, please let me know and I would do so. I like doing this. This is fun. Y'all see my new office? I've been working on it for like a month. I'm gonna do a video and show y'all my new office because it was a hot mess before and now it's kind of looking like my personality. Y'all see that booyah up there? Because I say booyah all the time. Anyway, guys, everything that you want in your life, whatever change that you want to make, it starts with you. You have to make the change. If you grow internally, I promise you'll become unstoppable. Envision whatever it is that you want, and then go get it. Give me some love, some likes, some hearts. Hey, Teresa, share the video. It may can help somebody. I appreciate that. Take care, guys. Good night. Booyah.